Hey guys, for those of you that have been following our IVF journey, it is now 13 days past transfer. We already know that obviously we had a negative test, but everybody, like I knew they would, were saying make sure you test on day 13, the same as the clinic.
So when I messaged the clinic to say we had got the negative, they obviously said the same. I'm so sorry, but please remember to do your test on day 13, which I did this morning. It was negative. So yeah, we knew we were out anyway, but unfortunately I was then woken at 5 o'clock this morning. Now I think this part's really important for me. I don't think I've really shared much of this part through our previous transfers. But I feel like it is really important to share how bad it is. So you've not only been hit in the face with a negative pregnancy test, the then aftermath of no longer taking all the hormones to now be on your period, and it is horrific. It is so painful. I can't even tell you how much pain I'm in right now. I was woke at 5 o'clock this morning. And so much pain and bleeding so heavy. Obviously you're on medication and stuff to make the lining of your womb so much thicker than it normally would be. So you're then having to shed all of that. So yeah, it is rough, it is so hard. So it's not only there's your negative test, it's like boom, here's the worst period of your life. Make sure you're in so much pain and just feeling absolutely horrific, which is how I'm feeling today. So excuse the look of me, but today is rough. It is sore, so painful. I think previously, even when we've shared our previous journeys, I've not really spoke about this part very much. But then when I was actually in pain this morning, I felt it was a bit unfair to not share this part. And
it's the real realities of
it. Yeah, it is the real realities. And it's not nice. And not maybe everybody experiences this after their negative. They maybe do go on to have a normal, regular period like they previously would. I have never had that. Mine has always been horrific after a negative test, after all the hormones and stuff. So for me, that's never been the case. Whether that could be worse because I do have endometriosis and polycystic ovaries, I don't know. I would hate to give the illusion that you get this negative test and then you move on with your life and you just get on with things and it's just easy peasy, because it's absolutely not. Even when we're on here and we're talking and stuff, does it cheer us up? Absolutely. But are you still hurting from what's just happened? Abso-frickin-lutely. And then you're hit with this. It's just another harsh reminder of what's not came of all that hard work and all that medication and all the suffering of what you were feeling with the hormones and stuff.
One thing that I've never said on here as well, and I don't have to because I've said to my wife, but I'm so grateful for everything that you've done for us as a couple. Like, you took... Oh, I know I go cry. You really took one for the team. I can't imagine if that was me.
Neither can I.
And regardless of the outcome, everything you've done for us and our family, and I'll forever be grateful for that.
Absolutely, and I'd do it a million times over. But today, not today, Satan, not today.
Not today. So that is day 13. So you don't have to comment about day 13 taking a pregnancy test. To be honest, we've taken a pregnancy test every night anyways, because I think that's such a normal thing to do. You could say to everybody, shout from the rooftops, it is negative, and I can guarantee you, you'll walk back out of the toilet and do another pregnancy test just to be absolutely 100% and hope that that's going to change, and it doesn't.
Yep. A lot of emotion, a lot of hormones, and a lot of different thoughts going through our heads, but we'll be good. But yeah, we'd just like to say thank you so much to everyone who has followed our journey, and I send so much love to anybody who is going through the same, and I really hope you get your positive outcome.